The question tonight is, do you feel comfortable digging that highway? Stuff got buried out there. Stuff got buried out there, and there are records of it that are available to the public. I represent 6 different community organizations that are seeking the release of the grand jury records. When you hear about thousands of samples, those thousands of samples were taken on the Superfund site because the process was sample a bunch. Do we like the answer? No. Do some more cleanup. Sample a bunch. Do we like the answer? No. Do it again. The samples that cleared the refuge were 5 samples for every 30 acres. Now, what got buried out there were things like barrels, so 55-gallon drums of transuranic waste, sludge from the ponds that was scraped. It got buried in trenches, it got buried in hollows, it got buried in places that people want to forget about. While everyone says that it's safe for unlimited use and unrestricted exposure, that is a surface determination based solely on a wildlife refuge worker running around on a four-wheeler. It is not about digging caissons to build a freeway. It is not about digging below 8 inches, which is what your current soil sampling is telling you. And so my concern is for the poor guy with the backhoe that puts that shovel into a barrel. That isn't 8 inches underground, it's 5 feet underground. And none of the sampling that anyone has ever done would ever know it was there. Our concern about why we think that the grand jury documents need to be released before this project goes forward, we're going to be looking at a situation like Hanford, where they've had barrels explode, and it isn't going to be one particle in one worker's lung. It is going to be a catastrophe for this area. All of us would just urge you that until we know more, this is irresponsible.